good evening, everybody, and welcome to an event of creativity and safety. My name is Renee Morgan, and I am the mayor, proud mayor, of Danville, California here, and I'd like to also thank all of you for being here this evening and taking your time to be a part of safety. You also are here to support the 11th annual Street Smarts Be Real video contest. The town of Danville is proud to host the awards ceremony here at the Village Theater. At this time, I'd like to take a moment and kind of thank some of the people that helped put these videos together. I know that students do a lot of the work themselves, but if it wasn't for the teachers, the principals, and the other people that help, as well as video production teachers in the classroom, I'd like to thank them, and if we could give them a round of applause, I would really appreciate that as well. The idea is that these teachers and parents alike give these students the tools and the opportunity to enter these competitions. This is a great way of us saying thank you to you, and also for all of us to say thank you for keeping safety in your schools. Now, let's get this party started. Yeah, time to do a little background on the video contest, and I'd like to at this time invite San Ramon Councilmember Scott Perkins up here to give you a little background on how this all started, and then we'll get into the videos. So, Scott Perkins.
Thank you very much, Mayor Morgan. And thank you all for coming out here tonight. These videos have been so much fun over the years. We've had some really funny ones, we've had some really serious ones, but they're all done with heart and with a lot of feeling, and we're really grateful that you take the time to put them together, and we're really looking forward to seeing what you've done tonight. This is how the contest works. The middle school students work in teams of up to four students. They create a 60-second public service announcement video about a specific traffic safety theme. And this year's theme was Be Safe, Be Smart, Be Seen. The overall message of their video should include one or more of the following. Be safe, be smart, be seen by drivers, whether you are riding your bike or walking across the street. Take care when walking in crosswalks without texting or talking on cell phones. Wear bright colors when riding your bike, scooter, skateboard, or when you're walking. And lastly, pay attention to your surroundings, which can prevent dangerous situations such as bike, pedestrian, or car accidents from occurring. This year's video contest resulted in receiving 50 videos from 115 students participating. The Street Smarts Program Advisory Committee reviewed all of the videos and selected 20 to move forward for consideration as finalists. The 20 finalists were screened by a group of video production experts who chose their first, second, and third place. Their judging process included strong consideration of several aspects of video production, including pre-production, which is most of the important stage of any video project. It includes writing the script, creating a storyboard, laying out the camera angles, reviewing the location. Next, post-production typically includes video editing, re-recording and editing the soundtrack, adding special effects and sound effects. The post-production phase can actually take longer than the actual filming of the video. Since there are so many quality videos this year, they increased the total finalists to 13, in which we will view all of them tonight. Thank you very much to our professional judges, Chris Verdugo, production manager, Contra Costa Television, Christian Meha, performing arts coordinator, Town of Danville, who's up in the booth tonight. Thank you, Christian. Matthew Pita, San Francisco State University broadcasting student, for their time making the tough decision of choosing the top finalists. This year's video contest resulted in the videos were also judged on content. How the theme is applied and presented. Creativity, does it hold interest? production quality, can it be viewed and heard clearly. Tonight, each finalist video will be shown in a random order. Then we will announce the third, second, and first place winners of the contest. We have wonderful prizes that include first place team, each member receives a $75 gift card. Second place team, each member receives a $50 gift card. Third place, each member receives a $25 gift card, and all remaining finalists, every member receives a $10 gift card. I'm eager to see these videos, so let's get started. This is how it will work. Our speakers will introduce each video, we'll watch the video, we'll ask the students to come on stage to receive their certificate and answer a question about their public service announcement. After we've watched all 13 videos, we will announce the top three. Remember, the theme tonight is be safe, be smart, be seen. The first video was created by Jared Fonkcha, seventh grader from Gale Ranch Middle School. So let's watch his video is titled, Be Safe, Stand Out. Let's watch.
We have rules for a reason. But when people don't follow these rules, people can get seriously hurt. And how long can we get away with this until we actually do get hurt? But let's turn back time just for this moment. And let's fix the mistakes that we made. First off, put the phone away when crossing the street. Look both ways before crossing the street and make eye contact with the driver so that you know when to cross. Also at night, make sure you wear light colors so that the driver doesn't hit you. And also at night when biking, have a reflector so you don't get hit also. Follow these rules and stay safe.
If we can have Jared come on up, please.
It's Mike.
Danger Enthusiasts, hosted by Jose.
Hi, I'm your average TV show host, and welcome to Street Danger Enthusiasts, where we interview not smart people, and they explain their not smart things. Let's go interview our first person.
So, Joe, is it? I heard that you're, addicted to walking across the street while looking at your cell phone because it's fun. Can you just explain to us how this all started?
So I was walking down the street from the course, right? Shooting some mad hoops along the way, you know how I do. And then I was coming across this crossroads and I was like, wait a minute, what if I take out my phone and look at it while crossing the street? So I walk across the street looking at my phone and then I get run over by a rooster driving a semi-truck.
Okay, Jose. You want to join me up here on the front? Oh, there he is. Here we go. Street Smarts Enthusiast. All right. So tell us, what gave you the idea for this?
Well, I don't know. I watch a lot of TV shows, and I thought I could somehow incorporate that into a street safety video, and I thought it would be, you know, pretty good.
Looks like it was a lot of fun to make.
Yeah, yeah.
Very good, and congratulations. Now I'd like to ask our supervisor, Candace Anderson, to come up and introduce the next three videos.
Good evening, everybody. And the third video tonight was created by an eighth grader, Anaya Goradia, and seventh graders, Tanaz and Ahmed and Sonia Ladunerie from Windermere Middle School. And their video is entitled Safety School 101. So let's watch.
Okay, students, open your textbooks to page 235 and give me one example of safety. Ooh, I know, crossing the road doesn't matter, but just getting onto the other side. That's not quite the answer.
You must look both ways and be cautious when crossing the road.
Yes, that's the correct answer. Now we're gonna watch a short video clip on what to do and what not to do.
Be seen.
Girls, if you would come up and join me on the stage. Okay, so Anaya, is that correct? Okay, Anaya, we've got your certificate for you. And Tanaz, that's you. And did I pronounce it correctly? Okay. And last but not least, Sonia. And I said it right too. Okay, so this was a fun movie to make. Was it hard to decide who was going to be the one who didn't have such a good answer and who was going to be the one who had the right answer? How did you decide who got to do that?
Yeah, we just picked. Like, she wanted to be the right student, and she wanted to be the wrong student.
Okay, well, and sometimes that's what we want to do in life. So the question I have for you, all three of you, after making this movie, do you have any great advice for your friends?
Just have fun and just enjoy it.
What she said.
Okay. Yeah, just, like, have fun with all your friends and all that.
Well, and making a film is a great way to build a firmer friendship. So thank you. And let's do a quick photo op. Come join me right here, if you would, please. Okay, thank you so much. Now, our fourth video was created by seventh graders Carson Foster and Darian Pack from Charlotte Wood Middle School. Sounds like they have some fans out there. And this video is entitled Adventures of Super Safety.
Be safe, be smart, be seen. I am Super Safety. What are you doing? Don't use your phone on the crosswalk.
My phone!
You're also not being seen on the crosswalk. Take off your hood.
Thanks for the help.
You're welcome. Just remember, be safe, be smart, be seen.
Okay, now that was a lot of fun. Carson and Darian, we need to have you come up here because I know the audience has a lot of questions. There was some amazing trick photography in that film, and we need some of your secrets. Oh, and it's not just anyone coming up. It's our Street Smart Safety. Woo! And we appreciate you coming in costume. Okay, and so which of you is Carson? You are Carson. Thank you, Carson. And you are Darian. Okay, so tell us a little bit about how did you figure out how to do those special effects? I mean, that was pretty amazing. And some of the martial arts at the end. So tell us a little bit about your cinematography secrets.
I'm going to give that to you.
You must be the expert.
All right, so we sort of started out with the green screen, and then we added it into the shot.
Well, and who was driving the car that had to come to a quick stop right in the middle of your parking lot at school?
It was my grandparents.
Oh, okay. Well, that was very nice of them to participate in. Now, that was a very fun film. Let's do a quick photo op right here. Great job, boys. Okay, our fifth video this evening was created by Emily Chen, Chloe Du, Catherine Shi, and Kia Vidaya, who are all eighth graders from Gale Ranch Middle School, and their video is entitled Be Smart and Avoid Disaster. Okay, girls, come join me on the stand. So come on up. Okay, Chloe, which of you is Chloe? And we've got for Chloe. And I'm assuming you are Catherine. And I'm assuming that you're Kia. So that had some really great ideas of how not to cross the street. How did you come up with the list?
So we just thought of something that would be, like, weird and funny that would get people's attention, but, like, you definitely shouldn't cross the street like that.
Okay. Well, and the other thing I really liked was your choice of music. And, of course, as most of you may know, we aren't allowed to use copywritten music, music that's been, someone actually has the copyright on. So you came up with some really fun music that really went along with what you were trying to portray. So how did you decide on the music? Who chose the music?
I did. It just went with the theme, kind of. Like, it was a fun video, so I thought fun music would go with it.
And it did. So thank you so much. Let's do a quick photo op. That was a fun, fabulous movie. And now I would like to invite up my friend and colleague, the Vice President of the San Ramon Valley Unified School District Board of Education, Mr. Ken Mintz.
Thank you, Candace. Hey, I'm really pleased and honored to be here representing the Board of Education tonight. Thank you so much for having me. You know, and I really want to thank all of our filmographers, if that's the right word. You know, the reason we do this program is for safety. And from a school district perspective, while academics is definitely our number one issue, we want to make sure everyone, you know, does really well in school, graduates, moves on to college and career. We want to make sure that everyone is safe doing it. And it's just great to see all the time and energy and fun that you put into these videos to help deliver that message of safety. Because it's not just safety being at school, it's about safety getting to school and getting back home safe as well. So, you know, I know it's a lot of fun doing these videos, but I'm really pleased that you took the time and energy, because it's not just the time that you put into it, but the time that everyone else who gets to see these videos gets to share those messages as well. So again, thank you so much for your participation. Let's see now. Our sixth video was created by Ryan Frankel, Jacob Ricard, and Brandon Hoffman, seventh graders from Charlotte Wood Middle School. Boy. The video is titled Three Ways to Be Safe, Be Smart, and Be Seen. Let's watch.
Hi, my name is Jacob, and I'm here to tell you how to be safe, be smart, and be seen. Make sure to always be safe by making eye contact with the driver before you cross the street. Stop. Make sure to always be smart by looking both ways before you cross the street. Make sure to always be seen by not wearing dark clothing when it's getting cloudy or dark.
Looks like it's getting dark. Better put this on.
We do all this to prevent this.
Wait, stop!
Brandon! No!
Can we have Brian, Jacob, and Brandon come up on stage?
You are
Brian.
Brian, there you go.
Thank you,
Jacob.
Brandon, congratulations, guys. So, quick question: how long did it take you to make this thing?
Approximately like 2.5 weeks, I guess.
2.5 weeks. A lot of time goes into it behind the scenes. You know, to make 1 minute video, it's amazing how long it takes. Whose idea was it? All three of you together?
Yeah.
Well, congratulations, guys. Good job. Why don't you stand over here for a quick picture? Now for our seventh video. It was created by Natalia Bobroff, Annie Ashton, and Ben Dowler, seventh graders from Los Cerros Middle School. The video is titled Special Safety Report. Let's watch.
Thanks, Erica, for that weather forecast. Now to Annie for a very special report on how to be safe, be smart, and be seen. Let's see it.
Thanks, Natalia. I'm here with a very special report on how to be safe, be smart, and be seen.
Watch out, little girl! Ah!
Wow, this is a great example of the opposite. Now, let's show the clips and show you a few videos on how to be safe, be smart, and be seen.
Studio.
Wow, those were some interesting ways. But that's all we have time for, so see you tomorrow on San Ramon Valley News.
Okay, can we have you join us up on stage?
You are
Natalia.
Natalia.
I'm Amy.
And you must be Ben.
Yeah.
Oh, very good. Okay, so what was the hardest part about making this video?
I would say probably the bike crash. It took a few tries to get it to look okay.
Now, did you need like an emergency services crew on hand for that bike crash, particularly if you did it several times?
No.
No? And no one got hurt, right? No one was hurt during all that. How about that opening scene with the revolving globe? Where'd that come from? That seemed like it was...
That was from the green screen room.
Green screen?
Yeah.
And then we added stuff.
Well, like, we had to, like, buy it, kind of, because our other one had, like, watermarks on it, so, yeah.
You can't have watermarks on a green screen. It's just different. Well, congratulations. Thanks for participating. Let's take a quick picture. I'd now like to invite Derek Krause, Deputy Chief of the San Ramon Valley Fire Protection District, to come on stage and introduce the next two videos.
Thank you, Ken Mintz. All right. Boy, I'm very impressed with the talent that's been on display tonight. I'll tell you, as someone, a firefighter who sometimes has to go out when accidents happen, it's very inspiring to see all of you making such efforts to prevent accidents from happening. It's a real heartbreaker for not just the families of the children involved, but also the firefighters too. We really feel for you when we see you guys in trouble. Okay, so I'm here to introduce a couple of videos. We'll start with the eighth grade video that was created by Advik Nagam, a sixth grader from Gale Ranch Middle School. And the video is titled Street Smarts Video.
Hi guys, it's yours truly, Advik Nagam. Thanks for watching my video. Today, you'll be learning about what you have to do when you come to a road with cars passing by and you'll get home safe each day.
Don't text while you cross because you never know when another car might hit you.
I'm gonna check for cars before I cross. I'll look left, then right, then left again. And there are no cars, so that means I have to get off my bike, and then I can cross. And I've got to the other side safely. Now I can ride on my bike again.
Steps and you can avoid injuries or even being bedridden.
Be safe, be smart, and be seen.
Have a safe day.
Advik, will you join me on stage, please? There you go, there's your certificate. Where's Anve? Is he out here in the audience?
Yeah, he's my brother.
Oh, yeah. He was in the video, too. Do you think you have some other safety videos in your future?
Yeah, because making this video is pretty fun. It was like my first time trying it.
And I've done some acting before, so I wonder how I can be in your next project. I could bump Anve, maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
All right. Come on over, let's take a picture. All right, the ninth video was created by Emily Chen, an eighth grader from Gale Ranch Middle School. The video is titled, At the Crosswalk. Let's watch.
Crosswalks aren't enough to ensure your safety on the road. Many people use the crosswalks incorrectly. Pedestrians like you have to be mindful of the crosswalk safety precautions. Here are some good and bad examples.
I should have put my phone away.
All right, Emily, will you please join me up here on the stage? Oh, I'm sorry, Emily could not make it tonight, so her friend Catherine will accept her certificate for her. Catherine, will you join me on stage? All right, accepting on behalf of Emily is Catherine. Do you want to say anything on behalf of Emily?
Thank you.
Let's take a picture. You know, you were in a previous project, right?
Yeah.
And Emily was involved in that one as well?
Yeah.
All right. Can you divulge any secrets about this one? I'm kind of wondering.
His name is Holly.
Okay, and was that was not real on the grass, right? It was something else?
It was frosting.
And did you have to rent the heavy equipment that was used in the film?
No, there's construction on the streets, so.
All right, glad to hear it. All right, come on over, let's take a picture. All right. Now I'd like to ask Danville Town Council member Lisa Blackwell to come to the stage to introduce the next two videos.
Hi, everyone. I was on the committee that watched all 35 to 50 of those videos, and let me tell you, it was a very hard choice, but I think we did a really good job so far. There are a lot of talented kids in this community, that's for sure. Our 10th video was created by Siddharth Mahesh Mani, 7th grader from Gale Ranch Middle School, and the video is titled Be Smart, Street Smart. So let's watch.
Ah, what a peaceful drive. Wait, is that a kid?
That poor boy. Because he was on his phone, and because he wasn't being street smart, he got hit by a car. Let's see the scene rewind if he were to look both ways before crossing this time.
Siddharth's going to come on up. That was amazing. How long did that take you to do that stopgap animation?
Well, it took probably about 4 to 5 weeks. Just the first 2 weeks, we were just setting up the sets and getting the script right. And after that, I just had to animate and edit it.
Okay, so how do you set that all up? I mean, do you take it and you move it each time and then you film it again? Is that...
Yeah. So basically, I had a little webcam, and then I had an animating program. So I just kept moving it, and then took a picture, moved it, took a picture, and then when you play it all together, it looks like the figure is just moving.
Oh my gosh, that was fantastic! All right, pictures, and we can get down. Okay, our 11th video was created by Mia Hill and Reagan Moore, and they are 7th graders from Iron Horse Middle School, and their video is titled "Street Smarts Rap." Let's watch.
Street smart.
Look before you cross the street. You'll never know who you'll meet. They might be on their phone and you wouldn't have known. And now you're black and blue because they ran over you. And when you're on a bike, wear a helmet that you like so before you become the big discussion. Wear a helmet to prevent a concussion. And when you're in the car, make sure that you are not on your phone or you'll break somebody's bone. The three simple rules to follow here are stop, look, and listen before you disappear.
Reagan and Mia, would you like to come on up? Oh, there we go. All right, girls, I have to ask, who wrote the rap and how did you come up with that?
I wrote the rap and I rapped it.
That was awesome. And did you collaborate on the words or did you just, you wrote it all on your own?
I wrote it all.
Oh, how fun. And then you probably staged it a little bit? Or?
Yeah.
Okay, that was awesome. You have a future in rapping. Okay, now I'd like to ask Mayor Morgan to come and do the last two finalists.
Wow, what great videos so far. We've got two left, so let's start with those right now. We've got our 12th video was created by Nate Ware and Carson Sabrave, 7th graders from Charlottewood Middle School.
It could be very important.
Now let's do this the right way.
Nate and Carson, come on up. What a fun video. So, whose little car was that?
That was my neighbor's. That is like a 5-year-old, and he let us borrow it.
Are you sure it's the neighbor's and not yours?
Yep.
So what was the best part of the video as far as the safety message that you guys think that you gave to everybody?
Answer.
Go ahead and answer it.
Okay, so the best part, I think, was just making sure that you're always seen and making sure that you're never distracted.
Good point, right? Good point, everybody. Let's take a picture. Good job. Okay, lucky number 13. Here we go. We've got our last one, which is Kiki George and Lexi Matarazzo, and it's our seventh graders from Charlotte Wood Middle School. And Lexi, come on up. Now, I understand that your partner in crime couldn't be here today. She's at a cheer competition, is that right?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're going to have to do all of it. Here's your certificate. Isn't that nice? Everybody's making fun of her already, right? So what would you say was the best part of the video?
Being hit.
Did it hurt?
No.
What made you want to film it in the dark?
I don't really know.
That's a good answer. I don't know. So what would you say the best part of the video was?
Getting hit.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you so much and congratulations.
Oh, we need a photo.
Photo op. So first of all, I'd like to mention that every single one of you are winners. You've entered a competition where we've narrowed it down to 13. So all of you should be so proud of your accomplishment this evening. Thank you. Let's have a round of applause for all of them, please. To the filmmakers, to the parents that helped you out, this is a phenomenal event, and it's also an opportunity for you to tell your fellow students what it means to be safe and what it means to make a video production.
Yes.
But at this time, what I'd like to do is I would like to have the opportunity to start with our awards.
So, this is for third place.
All right.
You ready?
Again, I'm ready.
Okay, here you go.
The third place winner is La La Land. No, wait, what does that say, Ken? I'm sorry.
Yeah, let me do it.
All right.
Special Safety Report, produced and directed by Natalia Barbara, Annie Ashton, and Ben Dowler, seventh graders from Los Cerros Middle School. Come on up.
The second place is going to Adventures of Super Safety, produced and directed by Carson Foster and Darian Pack of seventh graders at Charlotte Wood Middle School.
So now for the grand prize, the first place winner, Mayor Morgan, if you'd announce the winner.
Street Smarts Rap. Woo! That would be Mia Hill, Reagan Moore, seventh graders at Iron Horse Middle School. As you can see, the top three are on the stage, but the rest of you are in the audience. That does not mean you're not winners. Like I said, you are all winners to all of us. Thank you so much for entering. Thank you so much for coming tonight. And don't forget, be real and be safe. Good night, everybody.
Thank you.